Hi everyone, it's Hope Yoder with Embellish Maker, and we have a brand new update. I'm so excited about this update. Are you ready? Well, we just finished with the previous video that showed how we added the preview in the window, in the sequence window, and we also numbered the colors, yay, and down in this area, you can choose between all of the palette of colors in the matte thread, or you can see the colors used. But now let's go to a brand new page. So one of the things that has been updated is the emboss feature. We've added some superhero shapes. So if you click and open the Create tab and scroll over to the Emboss Designer and click to engage the designer, we now have 39 shapes. And so some of the latest shapes that we've added would be from shape 34. We have a Christmas tree. Let me just change this in a minute here. And then we have this explosion superhero. We're kind of thinking of what's popular now. And let me just type in the word super. And I am going to change the font to something big and beefy like this. And let's go up a little bit. So if you've not used the Emboss Designer, it actually is going to be trapping down the towel section, the fibers of the towel with thread. And the open area that spells super would be where the towel is not stitched down, so it fluffs through. And you can play with this. We've got videos on how to use this, but you can change the size or the type of pattern you want to embroider. You can add an outline or not. You can choose your own type of text or font, built-in font or true type font. You can do the border stitch, which would be around the outer edge and then the outer edge of the text with a run stitch or with a satin stitch. All right, and so we've got a shield, and then we have, they label this book, but it's supposed to be a different type of a superhero shield, but I guess that looks like a book as well. And here is another shield. So once you have what you like here, I'm going to go down a little bit. Let's get this a little smaller. I'm going to touch apply. We'll add an outline, and then I'll select OK. So when I click off on this area, this outline at the end, I am going to change to a different color, and then I can convert it, the outline, to a satin stitch. And for that satin stitch, I usually like to give myself a 4 millimeter. And then I like to add underlay and then select apply. So notice my apply is at the top. In the previous versions, the apply was at the bottom. So we moved it to the top so it's easier to find and use. So click apply, and this would be the superhero embossed bath towel. All right, so that's another update, but are you ready for it? I'm gonna close this to clean up my area. And I'm going to open a new page. Now, if you're wondering, I could have clicked on File and New, but instead I use my Control shortcut key, which is Command and the letter N. And by the way, on the RNK Club, I've done keyboard shortcut commands for Embellish Maker. Let me turn on the grid so that you can see the grid. And then I want to snap to grid. So I'm going to right click in the toolbar up here, and I'm going to make sure there's a check in Snap to Grid. So that's the first thing that I'm going to do. The next thing that I'm going to do is click on the Design tab. Are you ready? We're going to just make a straight line, super simple. I'm going to activate my straight line, and Snap to Grid means if I don't actually, let's just go over here, if I don't actually click, let's say I try to click in the middle, not quite on the crosshair. Notice when I clicked, it threw the line actually right in line with the grid. That's what Snap to Grid. Even if I don't click right on the point that I want, it will snap to the closest grid line. So that's pretty cool. So I just wanted a straight line. Now I'm going to right click with my mouse and I have a straight line. Let's come under the sequence window. So here we've got our preview of a straight line and we have stitches 0 because this is just artwork. So I have only created artwork. And if you do select this at 3D, you're really not going to get anything different because it's just artwork. Are you ready for this new tool? This is an automatic tool. So we're going to go under the Convert tab. And last update, we gave you Mylar and we had chenille, but now we have RicRac. So this is so exciting, you guys. So exciting. I'm going to show you a picture. Well, you probably saw it at the beginning of the video of a pillow that I made to show at a trade show. But here we go. One click. Boom. Done. I'm going to click on 3D and then I'm going to zoom in. This is RicRac. And so let's just change this to something a little lighter. And we'll just scroll over. There we go. So this will kind of be a happy RicRac. Now, down on the lower left is going to be the slow redraw. So I'm going to select that. And then you can just kind of see how this is going to be stitching. And here we go. So it is stitching RicRac. Notice there's no underlay there because it's a nice dense stitch that looks beautiful when you stitch it on fabric. So the pillow that you saw at the beginning has the RicRac, and I'll pop a picture and zoom in so you can see what this looks like. All right, so that's pretty awesome, isn't it? I know you guys are super excited. Are you excited? So now that I have this, I could, just to make the pillow, I just copy and pasted this, and then I changed the colors to different colors. Notice this, I have this little shortcut on here, and that's a Craft and Cut shortcut. Remember, Craft and Cut software, the tools load inside of Embellish Maker, and that's why when I select something, I have all of these little shortcuts. If you don't have those, don't worry. You can right-click and say copy, and then right-click and paste. Or you could go under this section and copy or paste, or right up here, copy and paste. So in the pillow, I've taken this RicRac, and I had single rows of RicRac, but then I also just kind of stack them right inside of each other like this. Well, actually, let me zoom out a little bit and zoom in just so we can see this. And I stacked them right on top of each other, and I made sure I overlapped them. And that is one of the ways that I made one of the pillow. All right, now let's take this one, and I'll copy this, and then I'll paste it, and then I'll drag it down. And let's change this to a different color. So here's one of the things that I did with this. Let's make this green. And now I'm going to paste another one. And it pasted it up here, and I have this blue. Now, another thing that you can do is you could mirror image this design. So if we come under, let's close this out to clean up my workspace. And if I come under transform, I could rotate this 90 degrees or this way. All right. Or I could have simply used the other icon. But now I've got them going a little bit facing each other, and I want them to end about the same place. So let's zoom in a little bit more. And now what I did is I just kind of stack those and overlap them. And then I will select both of them by holding down control on my keyboard. And here's another little shortcut. Under Align, you can horizontally center align them. Let's see what that looks like. All right. And nope, not what I wanted to do at all. So let's take this and let's turn it this way. Flip it horizontally. Now, let's see, that's what I wanted. All right, now let me select both of these again, and then I will align them, And then I've got some cool funky designs going on. Now you could stack three or four of these and do whatever you wanted and use it however you wanted. So that was making a straight line. But here's another thing that we could do. We could take and we could design by using different shapes. For instance, here is a circle. I'm going to click on it and I can make an oval or a circle. Hold down your control to make a circle. Now that I have a shape, if you'll look over in the sequence window, let me right click and collapse all of these. Now when I open this, notice under the stitches column, there's nothing there. That's because it's artwork. As opposed to opening this, and now I have 2,677 stitches. So let's go back to the artwork. Now I can open my convert tab and convert it to RicRac. So you can take just about any shape and convert it to RicRac. That's pretty cool, isn't it? All right, let me show you something else. This is awesome. Now, I don't have a picture of this yet, but we'll be putting the pictures up soon. Wouldn't you like to make some freestanding RicRac? Freestanding RicRac. So to do that, let me go ahead and just take this, all right, and I am going to paste it to a new page. And in the properties window, under RicRac, we don't have any underlay. The default is 4.2 millimeters and the density is -0.1. So I would recommend if you're going to embroider this on fabric, you don't change any of that. However, if you would like to make freestanding RicRac trim, let me show you how to do that. So here is the RicRac. 2,676 stitches, but to make freestanding RicRac, and what I mean by that is I would embroider this on one or two layers of Embellish Rinse Away Mesh Stabilizer with matte thread in the top and matte thread in the bobbin, matching colors and matching thread. And I would simply add underlay. Now remember, we're at 2,676 stitches. Right now I'll select contour and zigzag and then I need to select apply and watch what happens to this stitch. Boom. I'm at 3,560 stitches. And now let's watch this. And you're going to notice it's going to do some underlay. We've got the contour and now the zigzag. And then it's going to go over that and stitch the RicRac. Now again, make sure your bobbin thread matches your needle thread. Don't use a pre-wound, use the same thread and you're gonna get a beautiful trim that looks like you've purchased it. And don't forget, you can still do all of these really cool things back to back. You can make a really wide freestanding trim. How about making a key fob? Lots of possibilities, bracelets, little pull tabs for in the hoop zipper bag, or you could even make a wristlet and that could be the bracelet portion. So automatic Mylar, automatic RicRac, boom, Embellish Maker has brought this to you. I'm super excited. Please show us on our Facebook page what you do with the RicRac tool. Until next time, happy crafting.